Hello everyone, the last few seconds showed us getting out of Navi Mumbai. This is day one of our Rajasthan ride, which will last till the sunset. Here comes another toll booth. Expect around 7 to 8 toll booths from Mumbai to Ahmedabad. If you are driving by car, then the total toll amount should be around 600 rupees. We will be maintaining daily expense records, which will include food, fuel, stay and others. All this will be shared with you guys accordingly. Time to discuss the route which we are taking towards Ahmedabad. From Mumbai, it's the same Charoti route on the NH48, thereby following Vapi, Navsari, Bharuch, Vadodara, Anand and finally Ahmedabad. Of course, you don't need to enter these cities as there is always a bypass or the NH48 goes straight beside them. Vadodara to Ahmedabad has an expressway, but sadly no bikes are allowed over there. You won't be missing that expressway much as NH48 from Vadodara to Ahmedabad is in excellent condition. Navi Mumbai to Ahmedabad is around 600 plus kilometers and the roads are so good that at times the ride can get boring. So to make this ride interesting, we will discuss what all maintenance and stuff we have done before starting the ride. My last 2 days were spent totally on servicing the RTR 200 and the Dominar 400. Everything was done and tested by yesterday late evening. And by the end of it, we were so tired that we got a really good and deep sleep, which was very important for the ride. Time to bring the RTR 200 into the picture. Now last month I had updated on Instagram about my oil change. So this time I'm continuing with the same Motul 300V 10W40 fully synthetic engine oil. The 300V is marketed as a racing engine oil and touring conditions don't differ much as both the situation test the metal of the engine. Moreover, 8.4 mg of TBN is high enough to make the oil last long. Till now my experience has been really smooth. Let's see if it manages to maintain the same smoothness till the end of the ride. So let's start the discussion with the Dominar 400. For engine oil, this time we went for the Motul 7100 10W50 fully synthetic engine oil. With Group 5 Easter oil base, this oil should perform very well on long distance riding. But right now, we won't comment until we personally experience this oil's performance on this ride. The Dominar 400 has already done 9000 plus kilometers with the stock air filter, so we decided to change it with a new one. And I must say the changing process can get time consuming. This is the condition of the air filter after 9000 kilometers. Here goes the new air filter. I must say the Dominar 400 is breathing way better after the air filter change. This year again, I am very happy to see this group of cyclists. It's around 3 years and every year I come across them. This group of 50-60 cycle riders ride all the way from Chennai to Khetlaji in Pali, Rajasthan. Every time I see them, I do stop and wave at them. It's a small gesture from my side, but I know it boosts a huge amount of confidence in them to continue with the ride. Time for the fuel stop, and if you guys have seen my previous videos then you already know that I usually stop for fuel whenever the fuel level reaches the half tank. I still have one bar to go, but the Dominar is already at half tank, so we decided to have a fuel and water break. So guys entering Gujarat from Maharashtra or from MP should already be happy because petrol is a lot cheaper over here. Today morning we started with a full tank of fuel and both the bikes have done exactly the same kilometers. As you can see, the Dominar did 255.6 km in 7.47 liters of fuel, while the Artea did the same 255.6 km in 6.08 liters of fuel. All this calculates up to a fantastic fuel efficiency figure of 34.21 km per liter for the Dominar 400 and 42.03 km per liter for the Artea 200. This is the highest fuel efficiency figure I have ever achieved on my Artea 200. So we had stopped here for lunch. The Gujarati meal served here was filling and has certainly charged us for the next couple of 100 kilometers. Fuel efficiency figures depend upon a lot of factors, including good roads, how efficient your riding style is, tire air pressure, chain condition, engine oil, etc. etc. Still, I would take time in accepting 42 km per liter from a Artea 200. Let's see how much we get on our next fuel stop. Here we are stopping on the roadside as the Dominar is facing some problem. At first glance, this might seem to be a minor issue, but the bracket along with the speed sensor cable has come loose as the screw has fallen somewhere. Now, the metal bracket can hit the radiator at high speed or while turning, which can create a major problem. Right now we don't have a 10mm screw, so we are tying up the cable with a thread to secure it in its place. Some common maintenance carried on both the motorcycles include chain cleaning, lubrication, and adjusting the chain slackness. Apart from this, the disc, calipers, and brake pads were thoroughly cleaned with the STP brake cleaner. Spark plugs were inspected, coolant level on the Dominar was checked, and all the critical nut, bolts, and screws were tightened up. Finally, we are entering Ahmedabad city. We have booked our stay at Oyo Hotels. It's on the highway side with good eating joints nearby. And the most important thing is that it has got underground parking with CCTV securities. Finally, we entered the hotel with still some daylight in hand, and both the bikes have performed exceedingly well for the 600 km ride.